what went into making filming safe and securing the location and just even being able to get everyone back to start production?
I won't bore you because there's about 400 pages worth of notes that we had to make. It was a military type operation. And I honestly just, I don't think it could have happened if it hadn't been us. We were the first major production back. And if it hadn't been a family that's been together for 19 years, I honestly don't think it would have happened because we just had this crew from top to bottom that were dedicated to just taking the next step and getting to Palm Springs and just rolling tape and shooting a show. And that first night I looked around and thought, this is a miracle. I can't believe we're doing this. It was a Herculean effort from testing to lawyers, to executives. I mean, the bar, and we're shooting in California and we have a wonderful governor who would wake up and just change the rules because he felt like it. And so we had to roll with that. And so it was a mess, but a bunch of people were dedicated to making this happen. And we did.
Well, we are thrilled that this happened because, like I said, we just didn't know if we were ever going to get the show back, but we're getting it. Now, we saw that you dropped your son off at college, and then there were all these rumors that you were not allowed back. And honestly, we were all freaking out. We're like, Chris Harrison is not going to host the show. And then JoJo came in. Is that all true?
I did not go rogue, by the way. After 19 years, I didn't just go crazy and bust out of the set and run. It was like Escape from Alcatraz. But no, clearly I knew after 19 years, my son was going to college. Mm-hmm. And so normally it would not have been an issue. It would have been right in the middle of my off time and I would have been fine. But things changed and I knew Claire's season slid into that. And the producers, executives were so great about creating a way for me to do this safely. And unfortunately, I couldn't do it in just a day. I had to do it and then come back and go through the protocol again. And so, yeah, I needed some help. So you'll see some familiar faces help me out.
That is great. And it was kind of a funny, because rumors have been flying rampant all summer long. There's been so many crazy stories going around. But to have that story was one of my favorites and one of the funniest. It was like, he left to take his son to college and nobody knew. Like, what do you mean nobody knew?
It was as if I woke up after 18 and a half years and thought, holy crap, I have a son. He's going to college. I should show up for that. That's a good dad moment. It was obviously planned. And maybe I trolled everybody a little bit and leaned into the story with some of my posts, but it was too easy. I was having too much fun.
Definitely.
Yeah, that's another question I have for you, because I did see you lean into it. You posted that funny picture on Instagram. Now, obviously, the media runs crazy with rumors. Like Fran said, we saw it all summer long. What is your thought process when you see a headline? And, you know, I'm sure that you want everyone to know what's happening, but you can't say it. So how do you deal with seeing all these headlines?
I love it. I mean, it means you are a part of the social consciousness that's going on. It's kind of like when people say, do you like being spoofed on SNL or whatever? I'm like, do you know what it takes for you to be spoofed? That means they have to think that everybody knows this show and knows what everyone's talking about. And there was about 4 weeks in a row while we were shooting, we were the biggest news story in the country. And I'm thinking, we're not even on television right now. And we're the biggest television show. So it's a badge of honor. And I love that people are so excited and have this insatiable appetite. And I think people need us more than ever right now, man. People need an escape. They want to get away. There's so much craziness going on, whether it's COVID, whether it's politics. They want to settle down in front of their TV and just judge and watch some drama.